Hey guys, Aaron Cybertron Zhang here, and today I'm back with another episode of Road to Ranked, where I climb the online series 1 VGC ladder in Pokemon Scarlet and Violet and provide live commentary as I go. In this video, I'm going to be featuring the best ranking Drednaw team from the San Diego Regional Championships, which was the first major VGC regionals for Scarlet and Violet in North America. This team ended up finishing in the top 4, and it's a really cool hybrid between Rain and Trick Room. You've got Pelipper and Drednaw for one core of the team, but you also have Hariyama plus Farigiraf for a Trick Room mode for the team. To round things out, you've also got Assault Vest Flying Terra Kingambit. I think this is just really one of the strongest Kingambit sets that I've seen throughout Series 1. VGC, and Flying Terra plus Rain plus Assault Vest makes it really difficult to KO, and the final Pokemon is Meowscarada. As always, I'll do a quick breakdown of the team, but if you want to just skip to the battles, check out the timestamps down in the description below, and thank you so much as always for joining me. If you enjoy, I'd really appreciate it if you consider leaving a like on the video or subscribing to the channel. It really helps me out a ton, and thank you so much as always for joining. Anyway, let's dive into things. So just some quick context on the team. Like I mentioned, it finished in the top 4 of the San Diego Regional Championships, which had over 500 players, and that tournament had 10 Swiss rounds as well as the top 32 single elimination bracket. And so Aaron went 8-2 in the beginning Swiss rounds and then ended up winning the top 32 set, the top 16 set, and the top 8 set in order to make it all the way to top 4, right? And so overall, this team won 11 best of 3s in tournament play and lost 3 best of 3s, which is obviously an incredible record. In addition, if you look at the top 32 teams, which I'll link down in the description below, Aaron was actually the only player who had Farigiraf or Drednaw on his team. So no one else in the top 32 had either of those two Pokemon, which I think is really cool. At this tournament, Pelipper popped up a lot, but people were combining Pelipper with things like Water Tauros or Palafin, and this team specifically obviously had the Drednaw. So yeah, there's a really great in-depth team report written by Aaron about this team, also on Victory Road, which I'll link down in the description below. So please go check that out, and let's break down this team. So, talking about the team, of course, the first Pokemon to highlight here is Drednaw. Now, Drednaw is cool for a couple of reasons. It has unique typing between water and rock, and you also have pretty solid base attack, and so with Swift Swim, this Pokemon can deal large amounts of damage. Now, one thing that's interesting about Drednaw, at least in my experience using it, is that I'm often not using it to pick up big one-hit KOs. I'm mainly using it to just threaten a lot of damage across the board on my opponent's team. So you can use Drednaw in the early game to distribute a lot of damage and then use the remainder of the Pokemon to kind of close out the game. One thing that I think is really strong about this team is that every Pokemon can just deal large amounts of damage. You don't have something that's like fully supportive, for example. And so Drednaw can be used in the early game to just kind of distribute damage and then you clean up the game with the rest of your team. I've also had games where I go with the Trick Room component with the team and then use Pelipper Drednaw in the late game once I've chipped away at everything. Then everything is just like in liquidation KO range, for example, I can finish things off. You've got Grass Terra plus Terra Blast, which gives you unique coverage into opposing Water-type Pokemon, like Gastrodon, for example, which is really fun, and Grass Terra also doubles defensively for Drednaw, allowing you to take less damage from opposing Grass and Electric-type attacks. And so, yeah, I think Drednaw is a really interesting Pokemon, and it often can feel like a glass cannon, but if you can utilize this Pokemon correctly, even just one or two big hits with it can drastically swing the game into your favor. And so, Drednaw here is paired with Pelipper. This is a really bulky Pelipper set, as you can see, max HP and a lot of special defense investment, and the idea is to generally set up the Rain for the Drednaw as well as the Kingambit, but of course just go for good damage between the Hurricane and the Hydro Pump as well, and you've got Tailwind and Wide Guard just for support, very standard Pelipper set. Citrus Berry is on this because you already have Focus Sash occupied on Meowscarada and your bulky Pelipper here. You could also run Damp Rock as an item on Pelipper, that's something that has picked up in popularity recently, so just some food for thought if you want to consider a different item choice, and Grass Terra as well defensively here on Pelipper. So naturally, Pelipper and Drednaw, really solid lead. You've also got a really fun combo on this team with Hariyama and Farigiraf. The idea here is that Hariyama has Fake Out Pressure and Farigiraf can just set up Trick Room. With Armor Tail, it's really difficult to deny the Trick Room from Farigiraf unless you can just knock it out, because Fake Out doesn't work against this, as well as Priority Prankster Taunt, for example. And with Fake Out support from Hariyama, relatively difficult to actually deny Trick Room. So, yeah. The idea is that Farigiraf can deal pretty good damage between Dazzling Gleam and Psychic. You've got Fairy Terra, which first of all is valuable defensively, helps against those super effective Dark-type attacks, but also doubles down offensively with Dazzling Gleam. Helping Hand here just allows you to, you know, take attacks kind of to the next step and pick up those KOs, but I think as Aaron mentioned in the team report, he didn't actually utilize it very much, so you could replace it for something like a Hyper Voice or a Protect or just another utility move. Hariyama with Guts and Flame Orb is pretty standard here. The main thing to call out is that Steel Terra with Bullet Punch, and so, yeah, Steel Terra is really nice defensively, helps against Flying-type attacks and Fairy-type attacks, and combining it with Bullet Punch is also quite nice to get a little bit of increase in damage output that's valuable into Fairy-types like Sylveon, for example. So, Hariyama and Farigiraf, another core with this team. Finally, you've got standard Jolly Meowscarada. The one thing to call out here is that it has U-turn. Sometimes you'll see moves such as Sucker Punch, Trick Room, or even Toxic Spikes here. U-turn is nice in allowing you to lead something like the Drednaw plus the Meowscarada and just, like, you know, U-turn out, set up the rain, and then allow Drednaw to outspeed thanks to dynamic speed, which is pretty cool. You'd also go, like, Farigiraf plus the Meowscarada, U-turn out, set up Trick Room, bring out Kingambit, and just start sweeping, thus allowing you to conserve Meowscarada for the late game. The final Pokemon, I think, is actually the MVP of this team. I talked a lot about kind of like Drednaw, but one of the other reasons I wanted to feature this is because it has Assault Vest Flying Terra Kingambit. Now, Kingambit is just a really strong Pokemon. If you look at its base stats, really good base HP, attack, and defense to begin with. And it's not that speedy, but that's fine. You have Tailwind support from Pelipper and Trick Room support from the Farigiraf. The main thing is, with Flying Terra and Assault Vest, this thing is so difficult to knock out, right? You think about what's normally strong against Kingambit. Well, you've got Fighting-type attacks, Ground-type attacks, Fire-type attacks. Well, with Flying Terra, ground type is just completely useless against Kingambit, and fighting also, suddenly Kingambit can resist thanks to the Flying Terra, and fire can be a little bit scary, but between Assault Vest and the rain from Pelipper, you can actually take a lot of fire type attacks in the format quite well. So the idea is that this Pokemon can just stay on the field for a really long time, even longer when you have Pelipper setting up the rain for it, and it can just distribute a lot more damage than your opponent generally can because you have such high base attack with this Pokemon. So yeah, in my experience, there are a lot of different ways that you can play with the team. I highly recommend you reading the team report to see what Aaron suggests against different cores, but I always ask myself, okay, is there a possibility to just go Pelipper plus Drednaw or Hariyama plus Farigiraf? Because those often feel like the most maybe consistent leads that you can play around. But yeah, please read the team report to get some more in-depth insight, and let's quickly highlight some weaknesses. So for weaknesses, the first thing I kind of want to highlight is that with Hariyama and Farigiraf, like, this is a really good lead to set up Trick Room, but you're not always going to ensure Trick Room going up. For example, if your opponent has ways to stop your fake out, it can be pretty problematic. That can be done through a bunch of different ways. One of the main ones is Psychic Terrain. One of the other ones is just two Pokemon that, you know, are immune to fake out, whether it be because they have like Covert Cloak or just like ghost types, for example. So Golden Go plus something that Terra's into ghost, for example, can be an absolute nightmare, especially because this Hariyama does not have Wide Guard. In addition, as you'll notice on this team, you don't have Protect on Hariyama, Farigiraf, Kingambit, or the Pelipper, and that's not inherently a problem, but, you know, as the team becomes more public and more people know it, in best of one, your opponent can generally leverage that to their advantage, which can be a little bit scary. I think for Pelipper plus Drednaw, for example, opposing weather can be tough, and Drednaw often feels like a glass cannon, and so I think with this team in particular, when I was practicing, I just didn't make very good use of my Terras, and I often would try to defensively Terra to survive something. My opponent doesn't even use a super effective attack into that slot, and then I kind of waste my Terra, kind of limiting my optionality in the remainder of the battle. As you'll notice, almost all the Terras on this team are defensive, right? Grass on Drednaw, although you do have Terra Blast. Grass on Pelipper, Grass on Meowscarada, I classified that as a little bit more offensive. Flying on Kingambit, you know, Fairy on Farigiraf, and then Steel on Hariyama. So yeah, I think, like, be really mindful in terms of how you utilize your Terra and whether or not you really need to go for it, I think is something to consider. Naturally, I think, like, Kingambit, if you have already committed your Terra earlier, fighting type attacks are just an absolute nightmare to go up against. So fighting type Pokemon, fighting type attacks can be scary. Electric type Pokemon can be really awkward to go up against because of the Flying Terra. And so even pre-Terra, electric type attacks do decent amount of damage to you. Post-Terra, even scarier. I haven't personally actually played against like a Palmot with this team, but it's interesting because Palmot could cover for both the fighting weakness as well as the electric weakness should you Terra into flying, for example. And so, yeah. I think one of the other things about this team is taking like unfavorable trades. It's very easy to just bring out Drednaw, liquidation something for a lot of damage, but you don't KO them, and then they knock you out in return. So be mindful of that, because often that will not work in your favor as well. So yeah, those are just a couple of the things that I've run into, but let's get into these battles. Armourouge, Azumarill, Kingambit, Indeedee, Grimmsnarl, and Sylveon. Okay. Hey, I mean, we have Terra Grass with Drednaw, so I can use that for Azumarill. I think the main thing is, like, Indeedee Armourouge lead from their end, right? If they go with that, well, I've got Wide Guard and Liquidation. It's actually not bad. And then I could, like, take advantage of their Trick Room with Hariyama. And I think King Gambit's always really solid into matchups like this. Let's go with that. I think Farigiraf here, not really that valuable. There's not that much priority that I'm trying to block from the opposing side, and I don't think Dazzling or Psychic contribute much damage output. I think Meowscarada was really good here, so I could have considered bringing that, like, especially as a lead to U-turn out. Flower Trick being able to crit through Grimmsnarl Reflect is also nice, but it's going to be Armourouge Indeedee, sure. So it's interesting immediately, because it's like, do they just go for Trick Room? Because if so, I could like try to pick up a quick KO, then Wide Guard, or I could just Wide Guard right now. If I'm them, I'm definitely clicking Follow Me. It's just whether or not they have the conviction to go for like Expanding Force immediately. I don't know. I'm kind of down for a Wide Guard into Liquidation. Ooh, actually, Wide Guard Rock Slide, right? Because it gives me a flinch chance. And if they flinch as they try to, like, follow me, it really messes them up. I like this. Because, like, them setting up Trick Room in this matchup is not that bad. They're going to Terra, huh? Grass Terra, then? I guess it could be Grass Terra Energy Ball into our Drednaw. So there's the Terra, yep. Do you also have energy balls, my question? There's follow me. Okay, I don't think you'd go for follow me if you weren't trick rooming here personally, but I don't know. There's rock slide. Flinch would actually probably just win us the game here, honestly, because then I could just liquidation and then hurricane. But it is trick room. Yep. Okay, that's fine. Now I can pivot Pelipper out into Kingambit and then just protect Drednaw. This is what I really like about this team. Like, Pelipper Drednaw, like, really makes your opponent want to set up Trick Room, but then Hariyama and Kingambit can just take advantage of Trick Room, right? And they already Terra, so we have the advantage in terms of knowing that. AV Kingambit's a really good switch in here, unless they just Armor Cannon Pelipper, but I think that would be really wild. I also really want to see if they have, like, Energy Ball here on Armor Rouge. Yeah, that's why we confirm it. Okay, nice. That's really good to confirm. I wouldn't mind conserving Dread. I could even Terra here, but I like going for... do we need a Terra this? I'm not KOing Armor Rouge anyway with Dreadnought right now, even if I Terra, right? So follow me plus Armor Cannon makes sense. They could also helping hand Armor Cannon King Gambit. With Assault Vest and Rain, though, we're pretty well positioned. I don't mind going for Flying Terra here. And... Kowtow Cleave into Armor Rouge, switch Drednaw out into Pelipper. The only question is whether or not Kowtow Cleave would KO Drednaw, because then it's better to just try to KO Indeedee, but I was thinking there's a world in which Indeedee protects here as Armor Rouge attacks. But I think turns 1 and 2 have basically played out perfectly. One of the things we'll want to consider in this game is using late game Drednaw. One of the downsides, though, is I did just give up my Terra like this, and so late game Azumarill can cause me some problems given my core. Alright, they just follow me. That's perfect. So we'll knock out Indeedee. Energy Ball into Pelipper doesn't really scare me that much. Wait, that Armor Rouge is really slow. What? I mean, it's been speed for sure, right? I don't think King Gambit on this team has min speed. Yeah, it has a little bit of speed investment, so makes some sense. I'm just so used to Armor Rouge like being somewhat speedy, even when they're on like Armor Rouge into D cores. But so far so good. There's the Azumarill I was talking about though. Liquidation right now is looking really scary. Psychic Terrain is also a problem for me right now. But Pelipper also just pressures with Hurricane on Armor Rouge, but I guess they could just Expanding Force. I should Wide Guard here for sure, yeah. I will Kowtow Cleave Armor Rouge, Wide Guard. I'm a little bit nervous about how I beat Azumarill with all four Pokemon right now. I think Azumarill walls practically everything. There's Liquidation. Okay. And the Expanding Force, cool. Next turn, I can... The other thing is... Wow, okay, Armor Rouge is super bulky here. Last turn of rain, they'll go for another liquidation. Probably, they might consider energy balling this time around.
I think going for Flying Terra with Kingambit was a mistake. I think if I had just conserved Grass Terra for Drednaw, this would have been a lock. But Drednaw is now positioned to Rock Slide after this turn, which is good. How many turns of rain are left? It's the last turn of rain as well. I think I'll give up Kingambit right now. I'll Wide Guard again, even though it's obvious, because Energy Ball, I think, will survive with the Sliver. Yep, so there's Liquidation. But I think it was a mistake to not have conserved my Terra. I just Terra'd because I was worried about, like, Helping Hand, Armor Cannon, but the Rain and the Assault Vest we had, right? And the Energy Ball here, which is fine. I just didn't want to get one-shot by an Expanding Force. Yeah, and I survived that. Cool. Special Defense falls, Rain expires, Terrain also expires, and Trick Room expires. So a lot going on right now. But that should mean that there is no... there's no Protect on Armourish, if I had to guess. So I'm down to Rock Slide here and then switch Pelipper out into Hariyama, and then I can fake out Azumarill. But this Azumarill is a huge pain, honestly. Meowscarada would have been the answer into it, but it makes sense to bring Azumarill into the matchup. And Azumarill's often Grass Terra as well. Oh, they actually Aqua Jet into Pelipper. Okay, nice. That works out. Even better. That's really good damage into Azumarill. I can actually just fake out Rock Slide it now, so late game Drednaw still coming in the clutch. Because I was worried about them clicking Liquidation. I don't think it would KO us, but then they can Aqua Jet us the subsequent turn. But now Hariyama, even just like priority fake out right now into Azumarill is really nice damage, and it's Kingambit coming out, okay. With Kingambit out, and how much Rock Slide just did, I think I prefer fake out plus Rock Slide into Azumarill, because Azumarill is so often Assault Vested, and I really want this gone. Okay, Rock Slide should KO now. Nice. Good job, Drednaw. Doesn't miss. Chips away at Kingambit. It's a 3v1. A flinch here would definitely secure the game immediately. But even if not, I think we're still okay. It's Brick Break. Cool. It's fine. I think that actually ensures the win, unless it's super fast Gambit. Because now I can bring out Pelipper. I could still miss with Hydro Pump, so basically the play I'm thinking about is Tailwind into close combat. Because Pelipper, I would think, outspeeds Kingambit. Yeah, so like, unless you're really fast Kingambit, Tailwind will go off first before you attack, and then close combat just outspeeds and KOs Kingambit. Okay, there's Tailwind, good. Now the moment of truth. Well, actually, no, Hariyama is half of Pelipper speed, so with Tailwind, we essentially get to Pelipper speed. Oof, that was intense. Drednaw really came in the clutch with those Rock Slides, though. Like, that's one of the things that you can do with Drednaw with this team. I think I actually find it difficult to often pick up big one-hit knockouts with it, but you can, like, kind of soften your opponent's team and then use Drednaw to sweep things. It plays out pretty differently from something like, I don't know, Float Soul in Scarlet and Violet VGC, or if you played VGC back during like Sun and Moon, like Golduck, which is like, oh, let me just kind of destroy things with my most powerful water type attack and one-shot things. I think with this Drednaw, since like you don't have an offensive Terra, it's actually a defensive Terra, you're often like slowly chipping away at things and then finishing the game off. But yeah, in the end, I think that was a really interesting one where Trick Room went up. They ended up outspeeding both of my Pokemon under Trick Room, but it was still fine. And Kingambit put in a lot of work in terms of damage distribution. We stalled out Trick Room and then got the Drednaw to a point where it could just start dealing really good damage to everything. So, yeah. Okay. For this one, we've got Arcanine, Hatterene, Grimmsnarl, Rotom, Baxcalibur, and the Annihilabe. Very interesting. I actually really want to go with Farigiraf here and Hariyama. I don't know. Grass Terra Blast for Rotom is unexpected and strong, though. Like, it'd be so satisfying to just Terra Blast KO them. We have Kingambit to bait out Intimidate from Arcanine. And I have Steel Terra Hariyama. I mean, Meow Scarada is also really solid here, just being able to crit with Flower Trick, but... Pelipper Dread. Kingambit Hariyama. Meow Scarada is okay. I think there's a world in which I lead Hariyama for Farigiraf, but I don't know. I like applying pressure with Drednaw early. Like, once again, that's one of the cool things with this team, right? Where it's like, okay, often how are people going to respond to this? Try to set up their own means of speed control, and that's either maybe, like, their own Tailwind. And if they have their own Tailwind, I could, like, protect Drednaw, Tailwind with Pelipper on turn one. If they have their own Trick Room, I can just, like, do what we did in that previous game. Get some early damage off, and then go from there. It's gonna be Grimmsnarl and Annihilate. But yeah, this is why I was thinking Hariyama Farigiraf, because I get to fake out Grimmsnarl and then just Trick Room. I honestly want to just Hurricane Protect turn one. Could also defensively Terra Dread. Annihilate could also just protect on turn one. Okay, you know what? I'm actually going to try to just eliminate Grimmsnarl. I don't know if Hurricane was strong enough, so I went for Hydro Pump, but obviously the 20% chance to miss is kind of scary here. But basically, I think there's a world in which they just go protect, Annihilate, and set up one screen on turn one. Bulk up is what I'm worried about. Nice. Okay. Yeah, that's fine. Just really hope Hydro Pump does not miss from Pelipper now. Oh, Hurricane would have KO'd. That did so much. What? Oh my gosh. Okay, Hydro doesn't miss. Given how much that did, though, Hurricane was correct. I really thought Grimmsnarl would take that a little bit better with Reflect being up. But turn one works out quite well. The Terra there was just a cover for them potentially attacking or going for Terra with Annihilate. They brought Rotom, which is interesting because obviously I could Terra Blast then. They didn't set up Light Screen. But Rotom could defensively Terra. It would be nice to set up Tailwind. I don't mind switching into Hariyama and just Terra Blast Rotom. Can't help but think Farigiraf would have been better in the back though, because I think right now my neither Pokemon Terra, okay. Well, we get Grass Terra Blast, but Reflect is up. Yeah, it doesn't KO Rotom. Still really good damage, though. There's Thunderbolt. And no Citrus Berry. And then just Drain Punch. Okay, I'll take that. That is not a bad turn. Rotom not having Citrus Berry makes me wonder what item it has. Because I want to protect Drednaw, because I think it's fairly obvious that I would want to KO Rotom or click Fake Out onto it. Like, I want to knock off into Annihilate and protect with Drednaw right now. But I think I should have brought Meow Scarada or Farigiraf. I'm really Annihilate weak right now. They just Hydro Pump, though. Wow, well played. Okay. And Bulk Up. What a read. That was really well done. Wow. At least we get rid of Leftover, so your healing capabilities are a little worse. But I actually think, yeah, I didn't realize how Annihilate weak I was coming into this matchup. They should Thunderbolt Hariyama if they want to. I could see it Rotom now protecting. Like, I want to switch into Kingambit and Liquidation into Annihilate. That was such a good play by my opponent. Like, I felt like I had a good enough lead where even if they made a defensive play, it'd be okay. But I think that bulk up, yeah, it changes a lot. I also just didn't bring the right Pokemon in this matchup. Yeah, Rotom does not protect. I get Liquidation off. It's good damage. Thunderbolt. Dream Punch. Okay. They haven't Terra'd yet. That's the other concern. Also, Annihilate Rage Fist, like, stacks are adding up now, right? But yeah, I think, like, even if I had played this game perfectly, I'm just so limited based on what Pokemon I ended up bringing, because I'm really weak to Annihilate. Like, I could Sucker Punch and Hurricane, but they could just Thunderbolt, Drain Punch. The Drain Punch recovery is too much. I needed Meowscarada. Or Farigiraf. It's too much bulk to work against, even though turn one worked out perfectly. I went for Sucker Punch Hurricane, but... Oh! Wait, what? That actually gives me an out. Oh my gosh, how bulky is that thing? Oh, it's bulky. Okay, I was wondering, like, it didn't have Citrus Berry, but it actually had, Weaky Berry. And they have Discharge as well, wow. So, the adjustment I'd make in a best of three is... Prior, and I get paired, but it's fine, this game was over. Is I need more damage into Annihilate. Like, the problem was Annihilate with Drain Punch just is so good into Kingambit. Rotom was so good into Pelipper. Single Reflect really just kind of slowed down my damage output. I think Meowscarada over Hariyama would have been a lot better for me in this one. Because, like, Hariyama's just not good into Annihilate, right? You can't close combat it. I brought it mainly because I was like, oh, if they go Trick Room with Hatterene, I have Bullet Punch, and then Hariyama can kind of do a lot of damage to them under Trick Room. But... That wasn't the right approach. Yeah, I don't see a way of winning this. I guess I gotta play it out this one turn, but with Reflect, it's too brutal because we're using too many physical attackers. Another thing to consider if I wanted to, like, replay that is, like, lead Hariyama. I mean, Hariyama Farigiraf would have been okay in that one, honestly. I could fake out into Trick Room turn one and then, like, Dazzling Gleam, Close Combat, Grimmsnarl turn two, and then go from there. So... I think the Trick Room route would have been fine. I think bulk up leftovers, Annihilate plus Reflect support from Grimmsnarl was too much to deal with. And without a lot of good super effective damage into Annihilate, I was really limited in that battle. So the adjustment I would make is definitely bringing Farigiraf or Meowscarada. Honestly, I'd probably go Hariyama Farigiraf and then figure out what I want in the back. Because yeah, at least Farigiraf has like good damage into the Annihilate slot. But yeah, nicely done by my opponent and... Shout out to Rotom's bulk. Yeah, even with Terra Blast, unfortunately, you can see with Reflect, we just don't really do enough. And that one turn where they like fully read me was really good. I think even if I had gone Terra Blast into Rotom there, it still would have been hard because I didn't have enough late game damage output into Annihilate, right? But I guess if I eliminated the Rotom there, at least it paves the way for Pelipper to like Tailwind, but they didn't even Terra in that game, right? And they didn't need to, which makes it all the more scary. So yeah, Screens plus bulk of Annihilate definitely can be a tricky one, but they also played it super well. Okay, this looks very similar to the team that won San Diego Regionals. I feel really compelled to bring... Farigiraf. I don't think Dread is that good, but it does have Rock Slide for Volcarona. I guess I could always Grass Terra defensively, which is interesting. Farigiraf Dazzle with the Dazzling Gleam actually is pretty good damage. And then we have Psychic for Amoongus. I do think Meowscarada is pretty nice here because I can U-turn out immediately. I think I want Kingambit with Flying Terra. I don't think Hariyama's that good, but it is close combat into a couple things and Bullet Punch. Pelipper is actually interesting offensively here. I do think Hariyama close combat for Baxcalibur alone, though, makes it really tempting. But I don't know. I actually think Pelipper offensively here, we've got Hurricane into Volcarona, Amoongus, and Tauros, and Hydro Pump into the rest. That's not a bad enough... Like, that's a good enough reason for me to justify bringing it. But it's pretty cool. I think so far in the games that we feature, we've had different modes with the team, leaning a little bit away from Drednaw on this one, because they have Intimidate, they have a lot of bulk. I don't think we can, like, do enough damage with it quickly enough. Gambit, Volcarona, okay. I would say this is pretty scary. I'll survive a Kowtow Cleave on Farigiraf. What do I want to commit my Terra to? I think King Gambit, ideally. Like, what I want to do is Trick Room and U-turn here. Go out into Pelipper. But I'm worried about, like, a Heat Wave Kowtow Cleave just KOing Farigiraf, so I thought about defensively Terraing here on turn one. They're gonna Terra, though. Okay. Is it Dark Terra? Oof. I guess that's okay for now. U-turn will also actually be super effective into that. But... yeah, this got really scary really quickly, I think. Because I'm assuming Farigiraf isn't surviving the turn. Yeah, it's Heat Wave plus just Kowtow Cleave, presumably. So I could have defensively Terra there, but nah. I feel like Dark Terra King Gambit's not actually that common in the meta right now, so I was willing to take a little bit of a gamble, but it did not pay off for me. I will go into my King Gambit now. So now I can set up Tailwind with Pelipper. I was trying to play with Trick Room in this game, but I think Tailwind's the approach we're going to have to take. So I'm going to Terra... I can see them just going for a Rage Powder, so I'll Kowtow Cleave Volcarona and then Tailwind, and then the next turn I can Hydro Pump Volcarona, Brick Break into King Gambit. Flying AV Terra plus Rain is an incredible combo right now defensively, so that'll help us a bit. Funny enough, Drednaw actually would have been pretty sweet to have here. Imagine if I just, like, had Drednaw on the back, I bring it out right now, and then I could just click Rock Slide plus Hydro Pump. But, I don't know, Drednaw didn't look great in team preview here. Quiver Dance. Okay. Makes sense. That's pretty scary, because I think now even with Tailwind, I'm still slower. Since we don't really have that much speed here. But if as long as like Flame Body doesn't activate here, I still feel fine, honestly. Let's see. Oh, that also did so much. Citrus Berry, sure. Hydro Pump should still KO you. Yeah, and a low kick. Perfect. Okay, nice. A lot of momentum back into our favor. Break. Hydro Pump. I thought about doubling up on King Gambit because I could see Volcarona protecting, and I'm not sure Brick Break actually Oh, they're going to sucker Giga Drain, I see. Or sucker Heat Wave? Nope, they just split their damage. Okay. That makes sense. I don't know if Hydro KOs. Activates our berry as well. The main good thing is I have the speed advantage right now. Hydro doesn't miss. Nice. In rain, boosted. Does one shot Volcarona. Perfect. That's out of the way. Break onto their end. Not a KO. They bring out Amoongus. And I initially had Farigiraf to deal with the Amoongus, so it's kind of annoying. I've got Meowscarada, I've got Hurricane. Sucker Punch shouldn't KO either Mon here. It's a debate of whether or not Amoongus protects, in my opinion. Because I want to Kowtow Cleave and Hurricane Amoongus for a KO right now. Okay, Rage Powder is fine, I'll take that. Because I don't think Sucker Punch should KO either. They don't Sucker Punch either. Okay, that makes sense. They're probably just going for a Kowtow Cleave. But I think the pace of this battle is in my favor right now. Okay, we're just really trading, like, yeah, attack after attack. Pelipper faints. I get the free switch in into Meowscarada now. You could have Tauros. You could have Baxcalibur. Bax would be pretty scary, I suppose, but I could Sucker Punch it. Ooh, it's Tauros. Okay, well, that actually activates Defiant for me. And given that I still have Tailwind up, and I'm assuming they're Assault Vest on Kingambit. It's Mirror Herb. Makes sense. But with one turn of Tailwind left. Oh, wait. They could Aqua Jet this. Is plus two Aqua Jet in rain enough for a KO on a Kingambit? It might be. Oh, that's sick. Okay, Sucker Punch Flower Trick. Yep, there's the Aqua Jet. Okay, nice. Kingambit survives. So we should KO them. That didn't KO, but fortunately I doubled up into that slot. Wow, that was scary. It's impressive bulk from Kingambit, but basically I was... Okay, like... I could have lost, actually, if they had Sucker Punched Meowscarada. Because it would have broken Focus Sash. But now we should be good. Tailwind's over, but you can't knock out both Pokemon here. Yeah, I can just Sucker Punch and Flower Trick you, right? If you Aqua Jet, Flower Trick, even if it doesn't KO you, another one KOs. If you Aqua Jet or Close Combat, Meowscarada. Actually, no, we don't need a Sucker Punch here. Yeah, it's fine Brick Breaking and Flower Tricking. Because they get Aqua Jet. Okay. Yeah, that's fine. Meowscarada just wins the 1v1 now. This was a really interesting one, because I felt like the beginning of the game, like turn one, was really scary, but Tailwind from Pelipper... Oh, that actually also just one-shot. So, they are not the super defensive Tauros, which makes sense. But shout out, like, I feel like this game just highlights how bulky Kingambit is, because on both ends, Kingambit was just, like, taking all of these attacks with no problem. So, yeah, this Pokemon is just, I think, one of the best Pokemon in the format as we finish up Series 1, because... With the defensive Terra, it can stay on the field for a long time. It has a really good ability, and it can just deal large amounts of damage. Like, it's not generally going to pick up one-hit knockouts, but your opponents are also going to struggle to take care of Kingambit. Plus, with flying Terra and, like, rain plus Assault Vest, it's just really difficult to KO. So, yeah. I wish Farigiraf could have put in a little bit more work for us, because I thought it was really good in that matchup, but I just lost it on turn one. So, I think if I were to replay that, I'd consider trying to conserve Farigiraf a little bit better. Okay, we've got Murkrow, Golden Go, Hydreigon, Arcanine, Breloom, and Garchomp. So, kind of pretty classic Murkrow hyper offense. What's their Hariyama Farigiraf answer here? Especially with safety goggles. I think it's Golden Go, essentially. Golden Go is slightly scary. I honestly kind of want to use Drednaw Pelipper. It's just fear of, like, the Thunderbolt once again from Murkrow, but Drednaw Pelipper, Kingambit, and I think regular Farigiraf is actually really solid here just for Dazzling Gleam and Psychic. All right, let's try this out. I think Trick Room is pretty strong because the Farigiraf is enough bulk where it survives most Make It Rains from Golden Go, unless, like, their modest max special attack. But it would feel really bad to just lead Farigiraf and get one shot on turn one, right? So, yeah. Golden Go Hydreigon. Okay. Golden Go Hydreigon. I'm honestly down for a Protect and pivot out in Kingambit turn 1, because Kingambit then applies a lot of pressure on a Golden Go on turn 2, forcing a potential defensive Terra. And I can actually, yeah, with this, the next turn I can Sucker Punch and just Liquidation Golden Go. So they're not going to Terra or switch. Fine. A Dragon reveals Protect, so I know you're not Choice. That's good. Yeah, they have Thunderbolt. Okay, works for me. Let's think about how important flying Terra on Kingambit is. They have Garchomp on their team, so I actually think the answer is decently important. I'm content just clicking Liquidation in a Golden Go and Sucker Punch into it right now. The debate is whether or not I want to go for, like, Kowtow Cleave, because I think Golden Go here considers switching out. Liquidation. Nothing on that team can take other than Breloom, really. I'm down to Sucker Punch. But they do switch, yeah. What's coming out? Garchomp? Breloom, okay. Iron Head would have been my best bet there, then. But this is why I brought Farigiraf, because I can switch into Spore. Also, that did so much damage. Wow. Draco Meteor now, maybe? Okay, the Dark Pulse. I would expect to survive that. Yeah. Here's one thing that's interesting. I can actually switch into Farigiraf to block a potential Mach Punch from Breloom, which is kind of neat. So I'm actually pretty down to Liquidation Breloom right now, and then go into Farigiraf. The Golden Goal switch was just so obvious, though. Like, if I had just Iron Headed there, then they're forced to bring something else out. Sucker Punch plus Liquidation is looking so powerful. Nice. There's the Mach Punch block. There's Liquidation. Golden Goal is still really scary, honestly, but I think AB, Kingambit, Flying Terra, and Rain is also looking really good into their team. They finish off Drednaw. Not a bad trade. I can go out into Gambit now. So if they bring out Golden Go, I'll have to think about things, but if they bring out Garchomp, I think we can, like, switch Kingambit into Pelipper, Terra, Farigiraf, Trick Room. It is Golden Go, though. Wait, do I don't even want to Terra this turn. If I Terra flying, that works against me. I want to Kowtow Cleave Golden Go. And switch out into Pelipper, but they might read into that in Thunderbolt. I'll still do it, though, because I think Kowtow Cleave plus Sucker Punch can be a KO, and I think the Golden Go, or sorry, the Farigiraf plus Kingambit can win me this endgame. Here's a Terra. Steel Terra Golden Go would make me very happy to see, personally. Cool. That works. Dark Pulse, fine. Okay. That is frustrating. I think it still might be okay, though. Oh, they went for Thunderbolt anyway, so I wouldn't... Well, it matters in the sense that Kingambit ends up taking extra damage I didn't want to take, but... Yeah, this works out. Because now I just Terra Farigiraf, Sucker Punch, Golden Go. So, if the crit didn't happen, I'd have more HP, essentially, but whatever. Sucker Punch, Golden Go, Terra defensively, Trick Room. And then I think with Trick Room, Farigiraf, and Kingambit beats everything that they have. It could be, what, Garchomp, Arcanine, Murkrow? If it's Arcanine, you activate Defiant. If it's Garchomp, well, I have Fairy, Terra, Dazzling. And you've already Terra'd with your Golden Go. And if it's Arcanine... wait, just said Arcanine. Wait, Golden Go switches. Into Garchomp, okay. That switch is really smart, though, actually. That one, it keeps them in the game. It's a question of whether or not, like, Fairy, Dazzling Gleam plus Kowtow Cleave knocks out Garchomp. I'm not confident in that KOing, to be honest. I didn't need to Sucker Punch there either. Because, like, if Golden goes clicking Thunderbolt, that should imply its choice specs given how much it did to my Kingambit as well. Yeah, so I mean, I'm just going to Kowtow Cleave into Garchomp. Dazzling Gleam. Hydreigon should protect here. Yep. Them double protecting actually, I think, also gives me a shot. Because it's also really interesting now, do you... Yeah, this game, like, both of the times Golden Ghost switched out on me was so predictable, and I could have capitalized off of it so easily. Especially in this last turn, I was just worried about them, I don't know, doubling up on a Kingambit with, like, Thunderbolt plus, like, I don't know, Heat Waver and Earth Power, but I think that's so unlikely. Especially when they don't expect Fairy Terra from Farigiraf. Three turns of Trick Room. Farigiraf is slower, which works in my favor, because I could see them switching Hydreigon out into the Golden Ghost right now. Golden Ghost is actually what's scary. So I'm going to Kowtow Cleave that slot and Dazzling Gleam. My dream would be Garchomp switching out for some reason, but they don't switch either, which I think makes sense. Oh, that Dazzling did so much. Okay, we should knock out Garchomp. We're fine. I feel like I just don't have no idea how much damage to expect from Fairy Terra for Farigiraf. Beautiful. What a fun game. This team is so cool because it utilizes Tailwind and Trick Room in such a unique manner, in my opinion. So, yeah. Golden goes their last one. We outspeed. Trick Room is still up. I mean, they're such low HP. I think Assault Vest Kingambit Flying Terra on this team is just so good, though. So, yeah, let's just Kowtow Cleave. And... I wonder if Psychic just KOs. Because if so, I didn't even need to be worried, but I would expect it to survive. Yeah, this is why I was worried. I was like, if Garchomp survives, it Earthquakes, knocks out Kingambit, I can't knock out Golden Ghost with Psychic. But Fairy Terra plus Dazzling Gleam did way more than enough. I think in my head, I feel like I was like prepared for Assault Vest Garchomp. That was super bulky, but yeah. Even though we ended up winning this one, I don't know. I think like I could criticize my play and be like, the two times Golden Ghost switched out of the Sucker Punch, like I could have... gone for Iron Head or Kowtow Cleave to predict the switches, allowing me to just essentially get a free knockout. But I just wanted to hedge for them, like, playing really aggressively and staying in with Gold Golden and attacking, because I didn't want to risk anything. And, I don't know, if they had, like, a surprise Earth Power from the Hydreigon plus Thunderbolt double up onto my Kingambit, I would just lose the game immediately. So it's one of those where, like, risk versus reward-wise, I don't, like, I guess necessarily regret it, but, yeah. Especially since we ended up winning even in the end, right? Given that the Dazzle plus the Cleave was always the KO on a Garchomp, like, I really don't think there was much my opponent could have done other than hope for, like, a bunch of consecutive protects in that endgame. So, yeah. Anyway, that's going to be it for this one. Had a lot of fun, I think. As you can see, like, Drednaw isn't often going to sweep every Pokemon on the opposing team, but it's really good at either cleaning up games, like we saw in the first game, or applying a lot of early game pressure. And then your opponent, like, you know... I feel like Hyper fixates on just beating Pelipper and Drednaw, and then they don't really think as much about how do I beat like the potential Trick Room Corlets waiting in the back as well. So yeah, huge shout outs to Aaron for doing so well at San Diego Regionals with this team. Thank you as always for watching. If you enjoy, would really appreciate if you'd leave a like on the video. And yeah, thanks so much for joining me as always, and I'll see you all next time. All right, peace.